Hello everyone, how are you? Welcome to my new tutorial. This time let's make a nice coffee mug with this blue mandala design step by step. This is Barbara Mandala Tenerife and let's get started. I'm using Martha Stewart multi-surface acrylic without mixing the paint with pouring medium or water, just I do the shades with the white from the same brand. You will find the color names in the description below. This is dishwasher safe and this paint that you can cure in the oven. It's non-toxic and this is safe for everybody. I'm using my regular manicure dotting tool set from number 1 to 5 and this crystal clear dotting tool set. What I used in my previous video. You will need the alcohol with the cotton pad and just a bubble wrap to laying down my cup. I bought this plain coffee mug on Amazon and I washed it with the soapy water and the measurement is 9.5 cm by 8 cm. I'm just propping up the handle with this roll to make it more straight so I can center the mandala easier. One more tip for you before you start to paint. If somebody is a left hand or a right hand, make sure then you're gonna paint in the opposite side. So in a left hand, you paint on the right side. If it's right hand, you will paint in the left side. I'm going to wipe it down with some alcohol to get the oil residue off it. I'm gonna measure now with my small stencil when I'm gonna place the central dot. If you don't have, not worry about it. You can use a simple ruler and make the measurements of halfway on your mug. I'm beginning with the medium white dot in the center and I'm using the crystal number 4. I made my first 16 dots around the center and I'm using the manicure stylist number 1. You can get your blue shades, the darker color you use a little bit tiny of black and with the light blue you can use a little bit tiny of white color with the same brand. Very important information that for the mug painting you can use only multi-surface acrylic paint. I'm using Martha Stewart, that's why, but you can use Folkart as well. These two brands is the best of the use, the paint on mug. But the very important thing is, you don't mix your multi-surface acrylic with other brands. In the next step, I'm gonna use the manicure stylus number 3. And I'm just place the white dots on the blue dots. And with the same tool, we're gonna use a little bit of light shade of blue to fill it up the spaces. With the crystal number 2, I'm gonna place a little bit bigger blue dots on the top of the little small blue dot. And with the manicure dotting tool number 1, I'm just gonna place a little tiny dots on the top of this blue dot. After this, I'm gonna use only a toothpick to walk down with the dots all around, like this way. My next tool is a number 2 from the manicure dotting tool set and I'm gonna place a small tiny light blue dots on the top of the petal and with the number 1 I'm just gonna walk down but only on the right side. Now I'm gonna take the manicure dotting tool number 4 and I place the white dot on the top of that light blue row. And with the manicure stylist number 2, we're gonna walk down only on the right side with the white color. When I'm done with the crystal number 2, I'm gonna place dark blue dots between that petals, like this way. And with the manicure dotting tool number 1, we're gonna place a small tiny dot on the top of the blue dots. And with the toothpick, we just walk down in both sides with these tiny dots. Now I'm gonna take the manicure dotting tool number 2. And place a tiny blue dots on the top of this petal, like we did before. And we're gonna walk down with the manicure dotting tool number 1, but only on the left side this time. And this is makes a nice contrast between the lines. With the manicure dotting tool number 3, I place the white dot on the top of this light blue dots. And oops, I make a little mistake, but no worry about that, because if you do the same, you just wipe it off, because the paint is still wet, so you can repaint again. With the manicure stylus number 2, we're gonna walk down, same only on the left side, on the row. Now with the crystal number 1, I'm gonna place 2 small tiny dots with the light blue between these petals. And when it's done with the manicure dotting tool number 5, I'm gonna place the small white dot on the top of these 2 blue dots. The crystal number 3, I'm gonna place a bigger blue dot on the top of the white dots, exactly in the middle. After that, with the manicure stylus number 2, I'm gonna place a small dot on the top of these blue dots, and then I will be finishing that row with the number 2 walking down with the micro dots again around the blue row. With the number 4, we're gonna repeat the same with the light blue all around this blue dot, and with the number 2 we're gonna walk down in both sides with our small tiny dots. With the manicure dotting tool number 5, now we're gonna place a white dot on the top of this petal. And when you are done, I'm gonna using the manicure dotting tool number 3, and I'm gonna put 2 small dots next to this white dot. And after with the number 2, we just walk down on the side in the same way how we did before. With the crystal number 2, I'm gonna place the medium size white dot between these petals. And with the manicure dotting tool number 2, I'm gonna place 2 tiny dots on the top of these white dots. I'm gonna take my manicure dotting tool number 2 and with the light blue, we just walk up on that line. You can use 3 dots or 2 dots, which is more comfortable for you. Just make it more flower looks, our mandala. If you are done and happy with this, you can just keep it like this, but I just want to fill with one more line down there, and I'm using the crystal number 2 and number 1, and I'm switch them every one dot after all around. I'm not gonna paint the top of the mug where you're drinking. They say it's a safety to use it, but I just want to make sure then I'm not touching while I'm drinking from the mug. When it's ready, I'm gonna place 3 tiny dots on the top of the white with the manicure stylist number 2. This time I'm not gonna use any top dots. I'm just leave it like this, and now our mug is ready to bake after 24 hours. I'm gonna place in the oven in the middle, and I'm gonna use 110 Celsius for 35 minutes. After, I just wait the mug to cool down in the oven, and it's already ready to use. I hope you like this video. Please don't forget to subscribe for more videos and hit the likes button. Thank you very much for watching, and I want to see your mug, how you did after my video. Have a lovely day, everyone, and see you next time.